Hello everybody and welcome to your next Lego 5 tutorial. So in this tutorial, this tutorial is going to be a really exciting tutorial. It might be split up into one or two tutorials, not sure. But we're going to be learning about sprite animation. And sprite animation is like once you get it moving, it's like one of the best feelings in the world to see an animated sprite moving across the screen. It's really cool, and I'm going to be showing you how to do it. So this one is going to be this tutorial is going to be learning about doing sprite animation, and then my next tutorials are going to be teaching how to do individual sprite animation. 9 times out of 10, you're going to want to utilize spreadsheet animation. Most likely, if you have individual sprites that you want to do individual animation with, then you're gonna want to put them in a sprite sheet, but sometimes you're not able to put them into a sprite sheet, and I'll show you instances when you would actually need to do individual animation, but that's for the other tutorial. So what we need to do, what I need to do is change this tutorial name. And if you have any trouble with the last tutorials, don't be afraid to check my website. The source code is up for that. So anyways. What we need to do is just like when we were learning about keyboard events and such, when we were learning about timers, we were doing like direction and stuff like that to move the sprite. So I was saying that we needed the direction for a later tutorial, and this tutorial is it. So if we look at this image, we see that we have down animation, left, right, and up. So I'm gonna want to have my direction to set to down, left, right, and up. Now, one thing I really want you guys to note about this tutorial is don't just copy the code. If you copy the code, this tutorial is useless. Not all spreadsheets are going to be laid out like this. Some spreadsheets are just going to be horizontal, some may be vertical, some might not show the animations like this, they might show the animations in a sequence like this, etc., etc. And like all spreadsheets are different, and you have to actually know the concept of doing sprite animation, not just copying the code. So focus on the concept, make sure you understand it so that if you were to switch to a different API or something like that, then you would understand how to do it if you knew the syntax of the API. Just understand the functionality of it and how it works. So the order I'm going to put my E numbers is down, left, right, and up, and I have a reason for doing it in that order. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have direction. And I'm gonna do down, left, right, and up. Okay, so what we have our direction enum. Now, before we even go any farther, we're not using primitives anymore, so you can get rid of the primitives include, and we don't need any of these colors. So we'll just get a rid of unwanted code that we don't want. Now, for the X and Y position, even for shapes and stuff, you're most likely going to want to set it to float. Just because in like 3D programming, you normally use floats and stuff like that, and it gives you more preciseness, I would say, or more precision. Yeah, that's the right word. It gives you more precision in your programs, because if you don't want to move a whole space, you can move like 0.1 of a space or etc., etc. With floats, moving by a decimal or point floating point values are better in some cases. So we're just gonna set that to there, and what we're gonna do is add back our little friend, the draw variable right there. So since we're not using the mouse anymore, we can get rid of this install, and we can install the keyboard, and we can get rid of the mouse event source. So instead of just deleting all this, what I'm just gonna do is just change the keyboard events. So we have our keyboard event source, and we have everything loaded. So we have our bitmap loader from last tutorial, and all of this stuff should be recognizable to you. So we're gonna get rid of this code. So all this stuff had to do with the mouse, so we're gonna get rid of this. So what we're gonna do is just like in the tutorial before, what we're gonna do is that we're gonna set our player's position and our player's direction. So we have else if, and we're gonna say events dot type equals to Allegro event timer. Okay, so if it's time to update, then we only want to check input 60 times for, we only want to update our player position 60 frames per second. So you could indeed put input out here and set a direction and say direction equals blah blah blah, then you do so and so. You could do that, but there's no point in checking for keyboard input if we can't update it, because say your move speed is set to 5, but you move 2 times within that 60 seconds, your player would jump 10 spaces ahead because it doesn't match when the timer updated. And most likely that won't happen, but probably on slower end computers that might happen, that can't really match the amount of frames per second. So we want to prevent that, so we only check for input wherever we're updating. And for slower computers, it might be kind of inconvenient, but with computers today, they can relatively handle these types of games. But in the end, it really matters how you want to run your game. But anyways, well, we forgot to create a keyboard state, so let's create that right now. So we have Allegro keyboard state, and we'll just name it key state. And we have to get the key states. So ale get keyboard state and ampersand key state. Okay, so we got our key state. So now we have to do is ale key down, and key state. And we're gonna say if they press the down key, Allegro key down, then we do y plus equals move speed, and direction is gonna be equal to down. And we're gonna do this for every single direction. So what I'm gonna do is copy this, change that to else if. And we didn't even make a direction variable, did we? No. So when you make an integer called direction, and we'll set that to down, our starting direction is going to be equal to down. So we're going to, if they press the up key, then we're going to move the player up. And minus equals move speed. And for horizontal movement, else if L key down and key state. Allegro key right, and we'll just add an else if L key down and key state Allegro key left. Okay, so we'll say x plus equals move speed, and direction equals right. And last but not least, x minus equals move speed, and direction equals left. Okay, so we got our directions and everything set up. So if we were to run this program, we got our image, and we can move our image around. Okay, yay, we got our image moved around. And if you want to add an event to if they press the escape key closes, you can feel free to add that, but I won't show you to do it. You should know how to do it from the last tutorials. So essentially what we want to do is that we want to crop out our image. We don't want to draw the whole image. We want to draw out certain sections of the image to give us an animation. And I will be showing you that in the next tutorial, since my time's almost up in this video. But last but not least, we have our draw equals true there. So just like before, if we update here, then we just want to set draw to true. And we don't want to put the draw commands within the timer commands, because the draw commands aren't really lightweight. Take up, they're harder on the hardware, and we don't want to mess up our events. So we just set that right there. So that is it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and we'll continue in the next tutorial. So bye.